Dano84 back with Sly Cooper stuff once we get out of the intro. And we're back. Wow. Ba-bam. Right when we come back. Couldn't time that better. Dano84 back with more Sly Cooper 2, The Band of Thieves. Got the non-sponsored monster. Ready to do this, chapter 6. Or episode 6, sorry. Go right to that full screen. See what kind of trouble we're getting into now.
Following the trail of spice shipments, Kanata, we made our way up to Nunavut Bay, Canada, the secret hub of Jean Bisson's shipping empire. As a young man, he trekked across Canada to strike it rich during the gold rush of 1852. Kanata. An avid prospector, he took some chances and ended up buried alive in an avalanche.
Feels like I'm buried alive.
Ben Simple throwback. That looks like The Shining.
Miraculously, the quick freeze kept him alive, and 120 years later, thanks to global warming, he thawed out. A product of his time, he dreams of taming the wild north, damming every river and chopping down all the trees, with progress delivered at the sharp end of an axe. Shipping spice for the Claw Gang proved a lucrative way to bankroll his one-man war against nature. And yet, I have to feel a little sorry for him. He's just a normal guy from the 1850s. Back in his day, he'd be a hero, but today, he's a villain.
He's a villain.
Either way, that man's got more than his fair share of the clockwork parts. What a low-tech guy like Jean Bisson is doing with robot parts is a mystery. Yeah. I almost don't want to know. But as always, it's only a matter of time before I find out.
Well, which parts does he have? He's Kanata. He who tames the iron horse. Kanata. Canada, I know. Calm down, three commoners. Alright, we're gonna play as Sly.
I've got a lead on the clockwork parts. Head through town and out into the wilderness.
Oh, don't you know it's the Great White North? Look at the moose. Hello, moose. That's my welcome to Canada. Oh. That moose don't want to play around. Don't mind if I do, don't you know? What you got there? Safari. We're going way over there. Don't you know? Just like anything, I'm sure if I jump into the icy cold water. Oh, I got ran over. I mean, I heard the train. I tried to. Oh, yeah, it's R1, not L1. I would say I tried to run, but apparently that didn't work out too good.
I've got a lead on the clockwork parts. Head through town and out into the wilderness.
Don't you know I didn't do that correctly? Oh, now he's gonna face this way? Yeah.
That cabin may seem rustic, but don't be fooled. It's the control center for Jean Bisson's trade empire.
Jean Bisson.
Sneak inside and raid his files. You're sure to find out where he keeps his clockwork parts.
Ransacking his files doesn't sound hard. Now, climbing up a sheer rock wall? That'll be a challenge.
You're in luck. Before Jean Bisson took over, this used to be a popular destination for rock climbers. Some of their old wall hooks are still around.
I'm guessing I just jump and hit the circle button to latch on.
That's right. And remember to lean back before you spring off the hook. You'll get more altitude.
Thanks for the tip. I'll give it a try.
Just breaking and entering.
Jackpot, Sly! That's Jean Bizon!
Looks like he didn't notice me come in.
Just stay out of sight and take a picture of each of his train routes. They should narrow our search for his share of the clockwork parts.
Alright, I'm on it.
Hello, Arpeggio again.
Salutations, Mr. Arpeggio. Y'all got time to shoot the breeze?
Of course, for you chump always. Although must we communicate through that triple speakerphone?
Yeah, I can think better while my legs move. Pumps blood to your brain.
Yes, of course. One must keep blood in one's brain. But do tell, is there some pressing matter you'd like to discuss?
First off, are you still a-coming on schedule to get that Northern Lights battery?
Yes, we're well underway. My blimp should arrive at the end of the week.
Bullseye. For second, when you gonna give me a look-see at that clockwork brain of yours? I'd sure like to buy it off
you. Be song, you covetous troglodyte. You've already got the lion's share of the parts. Would you take my meager portion of the robotic bird for your own and strip me of all my earthly pleasures?
Easy there. What? A thief?
He bumped into the table. I didn't hit any button.
Hello, Arpeggio again.
Salutations, Mr. Arpeggio. Y'all got time to shoot the breeze?
Of course, for you chum always. Although must we communicate through that dreadful speakerphone?
Yeah, I can think better while my legs move. Pumps blood to your brain.
Yes, of course. One must keep blood in one's brain. But do tell, is there some pressing matter you'd like to discuss?
First off, are you still a-coming on schedule to get that Northern Lights battery?
Yes, we're well underway. My blimp should arrive at the end of the week.
Bullseye. For second, when you gonna give me a look-see at that clockwork brain of yours? I'd sure like to buy it off you.
Be song, you covetous troglodyte. You've already got the lion's share of the parts. Would you take my meager portion of the robotic bird for your own and strip me of all my earthly pleasures?
Easy there, partner. You're all up in a lather. It's just that I found some real use for the clockwork parts I got. Why, I put three of them in the engines of my best trains.
Sly, did you hear that? Bizon's hidden the Iron Horse blueprints in his trophy bass. Head for the fish on top of the fireplace and steal those plans.
Damn it.
Sounds like you're making capital use of your share of the robotic loot. But for now, the clockwork brain stays with me on the blip. Although, when I arrive to pick up the Northern Lights battery, I might be persuaded to give you a peek.
That'll do fine. By the way, you ready to giddy up into Perry for the final hoedown?
Yes! The blimp's hypnotist wavelengths conform to the specs drawn up by the Contessa. And Dimitri, before his
confession and
capture, did a bang-up job of distributing spice through his nightclub.
Sounds like all you're missing is some Northern Light electricity.
You're correct, sir. Yours is the final piece to the puzzle, the missing link. Once the battery is aboard, nothing will stand in the claw game's way. Paris will be ours.
Yeah, okay. So, I guess I'll be seeing you at the end of the week.
Right. Farewell, Bizon. Stiff upper lip. Ta-ta.
Excellent! Now get out of that cabin before you're spotted!
Just gonna take my time. I like he's breathing out spice. Or Cheeto dust. Maybe it's Cheeto dust that's spicy? I don't know.
After analyzing Bissot's decorating techniques, I think we'll find the other trophy bass above the mantle in the two remaining cabins.
Where's the other bottle? I don't know, I hear it clinking somewhere. Probably in this building.
Yep, just like I thought. Get to the fish above the mantle and steal those blueprints.
Piece of cheese. Well, topaz. Nobody sees nothing. It was an accident. Oh, yeah, that worked out. I like how the game screws you like that intentionally, because I totally could have snuck back out of here without any conflict. Because, yeah, I totally could have just jumped back and across. Thanks, game. Way to keep it classy. Oh, hell, that captain. Way over there. Oh, yeah, there's that. Bear traps everywhere.
Later.
last trophy bass is above the fireplace. Be careful.
Attention all cabin guards. I've heard tell from the boys in Ponderosa Cabin there's someone been in my hidden blueprints. Everyone stay sharp. This ain't no summer camp. I don't pay you boys to lollygag while there's a thief in these parts.
Alright, I'm sure they're gonna force me down the freaking fireplace as soon as I get it. Nope.
Exceptional work, Sly! That's the last of the blueprints!
Thank goodness. Excellent work! Now head back to the headquarters.
Armed with all three blueprints, we should be able to isolate and track the Iron Horse trains through that satellite dish.
Top of the mountain, huh? Shouldn't take long.
I'm still on a job? You gotta be kidding me. Oh, come on, man.
This appears to be the only way up. Keep an eye out for those rock climber wall hooks. They might be useful.
That was almost a poor jump.
This is great! We've got total access to the train's GPS system. It's all on my computer. Head back to the safe house. I'll crunch some numbers and give you and Murray the rundown.
Can I steal it now? Nope.
Thanks to Sly's efforts, we now know the location of all three of the local clockwork parts. Two lugs and a stomach.
Jeez, he does.
John Visson has grafted each piece to the engine in one of his Iron Horse trains. This improvement allows the trains to run all night and all day. We won't have the luxury of sneaking in while they're stopped. While they're in motion, the only way aboard is through a hatch on the caboose roof, which unfortunately has been locked down. These need to go. First, collect the spice gas from the balloons above town, and then land on the back of the caboose to blow off the locks. Once the way is cleared, I'll suit up and jump into Iron Horse number one while it passes near town. With some luck, we'll have the first clockwork lug in a few hours.
Thank you. there. Of course that would happen. All quiet. For you to be done, boy. I'm gonna get you this time. He just got taken out by the train. Oh, now you won't hurt.
How am I supposed to get up there to collect the spice gas?
Murray's already commandeered this ice plane. Jump on its strut, and he'll fly you up to a good paragliding altitude. Oh, and strap on a special vacuum backpack. It'll automatically collect the spice gas after you've popped a balloon.
Sounds like fun.
Once you've collected enough gas, you'll have to land directly on the train's caboose.
Why directly on the caboose?
Denatured spice gas is very unstable at lower altitudes.
Stable.
Unless you land on the caboose, you won't have time to get the gas tank to the lock before it blows up.
So you're saying I either land on the caboose or get blown to bits?
That's correct.
That sounds about like everything we do.
Mistress.
Hang on tight.
Seems like a very dangerous place to be riding on a plane. No judgment, though.
Remember to use your paraglider!
The spice gas is lighter than air. Popping balloons should keep you aloft.
I don't know if I'm gonna hit that one. Oh, barely. Yeah. I guess I'll go for this one. Sorry, I thought I was gonna. Damn. Well, that's how that happened. Dead and grab enough. I guess I could do that. Kind of drop quickly if I need to. If
You got a full tank of gas. Time to land on a caboose.
I'll go for this. Oh. One car too early. Damn it. Perfect if I had enough spice gas.
Get back to the ice plane. Two more cabooses to blow open.
Where is the ice plane? Oh, it's over there. Here we go again.
Gas tank is full. Find a caboose and try for a landing.
We'll follow this train right here. Woo. That was a little sketchy. I don't know why the ground is sparkling right there.
One more caboose. Try not to get blown up.
These guards are not very observant, considering I've been able to go back to a plane 3 times and they haven't stopped me. Just an observation. Thank you.
target the last caboose.
There's three cars and then the caboose. Almost ran in right into both. So there's a... Oh, there's another slime mission over there. Let's go check it out.
Slow down, Bentley. What happened?
Murray, he went out looking for a snack and got captured by Inspector Fox.
Carmelita? She's here?
She's always
where
we're at.
Don't worry, Bentley. I know how to handle her.
But I don't know where she's locked up Murray. I'm used to having all the facts.
Calm down. Carmelita's not cruel like the Contessa. I'll follow her without being seen. She's bound to check on Murray sooner or later.
Okay, that's a good plan. Just don't get caught too. I don't want to be alone again.
Say, how come she's not arresting anybody, you know? Me a rich boy.
Thank you. Hey, criminal. You doing okay in there? I know it's tight, but you won't get shocked if you hold still.
I'm okay. And thanks for that bag of jelly beans. I was starving.
Won't be long now. Once I bust the other members of your gang, we'll get out of here.
I'm grateful for the jelly beans and all, but aren't you on the outs with Interpol right now?
I'm an honest cop. Busting the Cooper gang will prove my innocence and show everyone that Constable Neela set me up.
You mean Captain Neela? I hear she got promoted.
Whatever. Just sit tight. I'm going to look for your pals.
Murray, I've come to break you out.
Fat chance. This thing is triple padlocked and Inspector Fox is carrying all the keys.
Come on, buddy. You know I'm an expert at pickpocketing.
She's tough, Sly. If you manage to get a key, you'd better run for it. Carmelita's sure to notice and chase after you.
Leave her to me.
Sneak up on me. Justice will find you. There's nowhere to hide. What? My keys!
Oh, damn it. I kind of thought that might happen. I was thinking if I ran towards the enemy. They would distract her, but clearly that didn't work out.
What just... Cooper?
Man, she's firing wild if they're going all the way up there. Way away. Yike.
You can't sneak up on me.
Apparently I can, because I just did.
Forever, coward.
Like hell I can't. Although, you know, it's funny. Since she knows I took her keys, you think she would just go right back to the hideout or to the cell. I know, it's a kid's game, but I'm just saying. Oof. Because, I mean, clearly I only took the keys so I could break Murray out.
Charlie horse standing in that box.
My pleasure. You know how I love to mess around with Carmelita.
Yeah.
Not
in
your
weird. See you back at the safe house.
Adrenaline burst. Run like a turtle's never run before. Press X to purchase. Capture guards and extract medicine from. Hover pack jumps by hovering in the air. Fist of flame. Turn ordinary punches into fiery ones. I feel like that would be cool. Can jump while carrying somebody? Roll through the level silently, press it. Obliteration silent. Finish off juggled enemies without attracting attention. That kind of seems worth it. Go for that. They're gonna make me want to steal more stuff.
Attention, man. This here's John.
According to this timetable,
Iron Horse number 1 should be passing by any time now.
I see it. It's moving awfully fast.
Just jump on the caboose and go in through the hatch. Piece of cake.
Oh, motherfucker. Not my fault. He hung onto the side. Like, that's bullshit. Sorry for the language, but what the heck? At least it puts it right there. That's how it should have went the first time. Damn. I'm not sure if I was gonna make those last two ones. This'll be fun. Money, 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 this is fun. Are you kidding? One on both sides. Yeah, Bentley, I don't know what to do here. We're gonna have to fight. Damn, I managed to knock one off. Oh, Yeah, the only thing I can think is we're gonna have to fight. Aha. We don't have to fight. What a rude awakening.
Outstanding. Chalk up one strange robot organ for us and one less iron horse train for John Bassan.
All right, two more trains to do that for, I bet. Or is that it?
Things are going great. We've already stolen one of Jean Bassan's three clockwork parts. However, Iron Horse 2 and 3 are going to be a little tougher to crack. First, I'll need to hop aboard Iron Horse 2 and do a little preemptive RC chopper strike to clear out the air defenses. Once cleared, it'll be up to Sly to work his magic in the interior to get at that second clockwork lung. Murray, you'll need to trap some of the local bear cubs in order to unlock a nearby ham car. We're gonna
need
to catch up with Iron Horse number 3. But don't worry, the cubs won't be hurt. Although I can't say the same for the guards.
Doesn't make total sense, but I will do it. Let's do his, just to get it out of the way. I almost ran right into the train.
What's up, Bentley? Here comes Iron Horse number 2. You and that RC chopper of yours ready?
We'll get the job done.
We'll get it done.
Provided I can catch up with that train!
I did it that easily.
This had better work. Sly won't stand a chance making it through this train unless I neutralize the aerial defenses. Good thing I outfitted the RC chopper with a new cannon. Let's see. The X button drops bombs and the square button shoots forward. I should bomb those missile launchers before things get ugly. Come on, baby, hold together.
Damn it. Excuse me. Worst time to sneeze. Me to not have to keep sneezing. We're gonna go kidnap some bear cubs. I'm sure nothing bad will happen with him falling asleep on the train tracks. I mean, it's not like we haven't seen anything happen.
No problem. I'll tear that fence apart.
The metal's too resilient for my bombs or your muscle. No, for this job, we're going to have to rely on a stronger force. The love of a mother or her child.
You got something to tell me?
Yeah, he already told us.
I've had the good fortune of locating two juvenile bear cubs. If you put them together inside that fence, they'd surely start fighting. Bears at that age are particularly antisocial. Noise from the squabbles should bring their mother around to free the angry youths.
I get ya. That big mama bear will be able to smash the fence no problem to free her cubs.
Yes.
That's correct.
Beware, cubs, for you are hunted by the Murray.
Don't sound so creepy about it.
Thank you.
This poor cub was just sleeping. I'm just like, yeah, you're going in a cage now.
Good work, Murray. I'll send you the coordinates to the next bear cub.
Oops! I did not mean to hit the bear. I feel like a jerk now. I didn't mean to hit the bear, I meant to stomp the ground. Keep going. They're still locked on to me. What the hell? There we go. That's why it's circle. Oh. Ooh. Perfect distraction. Run. Sketch. Yeah, you guys fight each other. That was ridiculous.
That was fast. The mother is already on her way.
Yeah, because she was right on my ass.
That was beautiful. Just like a nature documentary.
No.
Only more violent.
Horrible. Oh, was a horrible, horrible mess. That took way longer than it should have. And I don't know how to make fire fists, but I want to do that. Come on. Oh, shit. Sorry. One on top of the house. Well, that was nice and quiet. And down she goes. Did not mean for that to happen. We needed a good reset on everybody anyways. I've almost got them all for this level. Oh, there's two in this boat? I'd like to say I probably could get them all for this level. That puts me at 5 more left. I'd probably get them all because I think I've seen them all. Carmelita zapping people? Yep. Exactly what that is. just like in Sly 1, I'll get all the bottles on one level and then realize, like, hey, I probably should have did that the whole time. What?
Relax, Bentley. There's more than one way to get on top of that caboose.
That was just not the way. Pretty much got to take off from this checkpoint. Like, no hesitation.
Sly, grab the pipe on the caboose to catch hold and climb on top!
Whew. Yeah, like, no hesitation.
The other clockwork lug should be hooked into the engine's furnace. Sneak your way up there and grab it!
I couldn't be any closer to him. Silent work, takedown work until you make too much noise.
Attention, Iron Horse number two. In case you haven't heard, some lucky worker managed to make off with the clockwork lug and Iron
Horse.
That
was a little interesting. So a single jump ain't gonna work. Double jump feels like it'd be too long though. Gotcha. Alright, now.
Attention, Iron Horse number two. In case you haven't heard, some lucky Marvin managed to make off with the clockwork lug in Iron Horse one.
Woo!
All the guards on duty have been punished according to the lumberjack code.
Yeah, just give up. Jeez. That's a lot of guards. I think I'm gonna get him to turn away. Shit. The one in the back. Ah! He might turn away. Aim. Oh my, you son of a bitch. He's got like hyper focused aim. They're like spot on. Well, we cleared out both cards though. Well, there is that. Yeah, they were like spot on aim. Get me off this crazy thing! 20 out of 23, getting there. 22 out of 23.
Alright! Okay guys, this is it!
I knew it.
Time to break into Iron Horse number 3.
Iron Horse number three.
Clockwork stuff. Now the train's moving too fast to jump onto here in town.
Never.
So we'll have to catch up with it on Murray's new handcar. Once we're in position, Sly will hop aboard and make his way up to the engine. While he travels through the interior, I'll provide air support with my RC chopper. I've planned this as a textbook train robbery. If we all do our jobs right, what could possibly go wrong?
Nothing. Nothing could possibly go wrong. Of course, first thing I need is Murray. It's already gone wrong. Ah. Let's go.
Hop aboard, guys. We've got a train to catch.
Good thing we didn't go right after the train.
Got it. Strong work.
This is pretty bog standard train robbery. If yeah, Red Dead has taught me anything.
Sure. But Murray's strength knows no limit.
You're on, Sly. Break into that train and steal the clockwork stomach.
That Jean Bassan's one strange guy. The claw gang divides up the clockwork parts and he walks away with the stomach and lungs? It still creeps me out.
Get creeped out later when we aren't riding an antique handcar at breakneck speeds.
Good point. It's time for a train.
Yeah, why'd he get 3 pieces though? That's the better question. Give me that air support. Your freaking laser focused shots here. Yeah, okay. No. I tried jumping on the damn thing. Problem one solved. Now. Am I supposed to crawl? Oh. Okay. That would be why. I'm supposed to go under it like this. I suppose that makes the most sense. Although, obvious flaw in their security system.
Ain't nobody getting past me. That there clockwork stomach is as safe as a snowman in winter. I'd like to meet the varmint that's been looting my iron horse trains. By Jiminy, I get hot neath the collar just thinking about how I cut that boy down. I'd kill him like a spotted owl. I sure would.
Where's my damn air support?
Hey, Cooper! Thought I might find you here. Just can't stay away from these clockwork parts, can you?
Oh, I just do it to meet exciting ladies like yourself.
If you'd like some excitement, why not climb up on top of the train? I'm sure to get your heart pumping, maybe even show you my new ride.
No thanks,
Neela. Why is
she
so reclined?
I've seen enough already.
What's the problem, Poodle? Afraid you can't take me on? Have to call up your little friends for help.
Come in, little friends. Neela's got me pinned down. Any chance of air support?
I've already launched the RC chopper.
Got the Bentley chopper.
Don't know what hit her.
Come on, Cooper. Let's play. What in blazes? All right, little RC friend. This should be a quick bit of destruction.
Just in time before
that
I got
fancy flying, little friend.
Whatever you say, Poodle.
Yeah, Poodle, we destroyed my RC copter.
Hey, Sly, get to that clockwork stomach fast. This old hand cart is starting to fall apart.
Go back to sleep, my friend. To the back side of the train. Why? Oh my gosh, this is gonna be difficult. I mean, kudos to them for giving us a section that shows he's a raccoon. That definitely looks like the way a raccoon would move. Thank you. You know what? Screw it. Run! Uh-huh.
Never
I was gonna laugh if he shot me in the back
day.
Right there, though.
My stomach got turned into a tool of evil.
Looks like John Basson's wised up and bolted the stomach down. We'll have to crack the engine block to get it free.
Then that's just what we'll do. A well-placed bomb down the train's smokestack will knock it loose. Just make sure to take some cover.
Not so fast, chum. The clockwork part is mine. They will all be mine.
Here's stuff, but I don't see it, so I'm okay. Oh, there, now I see it.
Damage alert, she's taking
himself in there.
Sly!
That'll do it.
Sly! You okay?
Of course we're okay.
I've got an upset stomach on my hands, but other than that, I feel great.
Nailed it.
The gang and I had pulled off the impossible. We'd successfully robbed all of John Basson's iron horse trains, and we were walking away with three, count them, three nice clockwork parts. And as a bonus, we shut down spice distribution in all of North America. Needless to say, we were pretty pleased with ourselves.
We were pleased.
Can't say the same for Carmelita. Once again, the framed policewoman had to run from the cops, which was fun at first, but I'm starting to feel a little sorry for her. I mean, what if they replace Carmelita with someone else? I don't want another cop on my tail. She's a big part of why this is all fun. Sooner or later, I'm gonna have to figure out a way to clear her name. Some way other than turning myself in.
Some way other than that. Oh, we got somebody different. So Bison doesn't get a double, a double level either. So the first one and the last one. Or this one, Bison one. So there's two more levels left in this game, so we're gonna take a break for this one, and we'll see you in the next video as we play more Sly 2 as we work our way to the end. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.